Dear fellow countrymen, before I discuss the resolution, I want you to understand two things very clearly and to consider them from the same point of view from which I am placing them before you. There are many people who ask me whether I am the same man that I was in 1920 or whether there has been any change in me or you. You are right in asking that question. Let me, however, hasten to assure that I am that same Gandhi as I was in 1920. I did not change in any fundamental respect. I attach the same importance to non-violence that I did then. If at all, my emphasis on it has grown stronger. There is no real contradiction between the present resolution and my previous writings and utterances. Occasions like the present do not occur in everybody's and rarely in anybody's life. I want you to know and feel that there is nothing but purest ahimsa in all that I am saying and doing today. The draft resolution of the working committee is based on ahimsa. The contemplated struggle similarly has its roots in ahimsa. God has vouchsafed to me a priceless gift in the weapon of ahimsa. I and my ahimsa are on our trail today. If the present crisis, when the earth is being scorched by the flames of ahimsa and crying for deliverance, I fail to make the use of the God-gift talent, then God will never forgive me, and I shall be judged unworthy of the greatest gift. Ours is not a drive for power, but purely a non-violent fight for India's independence. The Congress is unconcerned as to who will rule, but when freedom is attained, the power, when it comes, will belong to the people of India, and it will be for them to decide to whom it plays in the interest in. I believe that in the history of this world, there has not been a more genuinely democratic struggle for freedom than ours. Forget the differences between Hindus and Muslims and think of yourselves as Indians only, engaged in the common struggle for independence. The people say that they are disgusted with the behavior of British. Our quarrel is not with the British people. We fight their imperialism. The proposal for the withdrawal of British power did not come out of anger. It came to enable India to play its due part at the present critical juncture. I know the British government will not be able to withhold freedom from us when we have made enough self-sacrifice. We must therefore purge ourselves of hatred. People may laugh, nevertheless, that is my claim. At a time when I may have to launch the biggest struggle of my life, I may not harbor hatred against anybody. Thank you.
On 8th August 1942, to drive out Britishers from India, Mahatma Gandhi started a mass movement, the Quit India Movement, with the known slogan Do or Die. During World War II, Britishers tried to pursue Indian leaders in order to garner their support. Let us see under what circumstances Congress decided to launch this movement in the leadership of Mahatma Gandhi with the aim of immediate end of British rule in India.
Nididao India de ma?
No, not yet.
Xing xiao fu de hao.
We need reinforcements. Japan will take over. We need India.
Yes, sir. We will check with India. हम चाहते हैं कि आप युद्ध क्षेत्र में सैनिक भेजें।
ठीक है, मगर हमारी भी एक शर्त है। हमें डोमिनियन का दर्जा दो।
नहीं नहीं, हम ऐसा नहीं कर सकते।
तो हम आपकी मदद क्यों करें? आपकी मदद करके हमें क्या मिलेगा? हम जा रहे हैं।
वो हमारी मांगों को पूरा नहीं कर रहे हैं और हमें हमारी अनुमति के बिना ही एक युद्ध के बीच भी डाल दिया।
हाँ, वो ऐसा ही करते रहेंगे।
हमें कांग्रेस छोड़नी होगी, इससे ना तो वो हमें कुछ कह पाएंगे और ना कुछ कर पाएंगे।
हमें कांग्रेस छोड़नी होगी।
चलो कांग्रेस छोड़ देते हैं।
सर क्रिप्स, वी नीड रीइंफोर्समेंट्स। जापान विल टेक ओवर। वी नीड इंडिया।
यस, वी डू। We do need them, or to be more precise, we need them so that we could use them.
Yes, but how?
Well, it's like when you promise a child a chocolate, so to say, in return for his favor. And then the child does everything in his power and his ability to facilitate that which suffices you. And the beauty of this is that the entire power resides in your hand from the absolute start till the very end. With the best thing being you don't lose anything.
In 1942, in order to appease the Indian leaders, Britishers set up a commission under Sir Richard Stafford Cripps. Let us see what this commission proposed to our leaders.
Namaskar, हमारे पास आपके लिए प्रस्ताव है।
कैसा प्रस्ताव?
जिसके अंतर्गत यदि भारतीय चाहें तो अपना एक भारतीय प्रभुत्व स्थापित कर सकते हैं, जिसके अंतर्गत डोमिनियन के पास ब्रिटिश राष्ट्रमंडल का हिस्सा बनने का अवसर होगा और जिसके अंतर्गत वो सभी प्रांत जो भारतीय प्रभुत्व का हिस्सा बनने को तैयार नहीं, वह अपना एक अलग संविधान बना सकते हैं। यदि आप हमारी माने तो इस प्रस्ताव को बिना समय गवाए स्वीकार करें, क्योंकि ऐसे प्रस्ताव हर दिन नहीं आया करते।
हम इस पर विचार करेंगे।
नहीं, हम इस प्रस्ताव को स्वीकार नहीं कर सकते। यह अपने दृष्टिकोण में बहुत सतर्क है।
अलग अलग यूनियन बनाने का अधिकार हमारी राष्ट्रीय एकता को नुकसान पहुंचाएगा और ये ब्रिटिश सरकार की मंशा को भी दिखाता है कि वे हमें आजादी नहीं देंगे।
हम पूर्ण स्वतंत्रता चाहते हैं और ब्रिटिश शासन का अंत चाहते हैं।
हमें पूर्ण स्वराज चाहिए।
तुम सही हो, अब हम इसे और बर्दाश्त नहीं कर सकते। प्रत्येक भारतीय जो इसके लिए स्वतंत्रता चाहता है, उसे अपने स्वयं का मार्गदर्शक होना चाहिए, जो उसे एक लंबी कठिन सड़क पर जाने का आग्रह करता है, जहां कोई विश्राम स्थल नहीं है, जो अंततः भारत की स्वतंत्रता की ओर ले जाता है। इस क्षण से आप में से एक प्रत्येक को अपने आप को एक स्वतंत्र पुरुष या स्त्री के रूप में समझना चाहिए। करो या मरो, हम या तो भारत को आजाद कर देंगे या इस प्रयास में मर जाएंगे।
अंग्रेजों भारत छोड़ो, अंग्रेजों भारत छोड़ो,
अंग्रेजों भारत छोड़ो, अंग्रेजों भारत छोड़ो।
द वेरी नेक्स्ट डे ऑन 9th अगस्त 1942 ऑल इम्पोर्टेंट लीडर्स इंक्लूडिंग गांधी जी वर अरेस्टेड एंड इम्प्रिजन्ड। द ब्रिटिशर्स मैनेज्ड टू कर्व द मूवमेंट बट इट कम्प्लीटली शुक द रूट्स ऑफ द ब्रिटिश एम्पायर। They made a clear message to the Britishers that their rule in India will not continue for long.
Freedom in their mind, faith in their words, and pride in their heart. Good morning, one and all present here. Today, I, Prakhar Jha, would like to brief about the movement which brought India to the brink of independence, the Quit India Movement. The Quit India Movement was launched by the All India Congress Committee by Mahatma Gandhi on 8th August 1942, demanding an immediate end to the British rule in India. The Cripps mission had already failed, and on 8th August 1942, Gandhiji made a call to do or die in his Quit India Movement speech delivered in Bombay at the Gwalior Tank Maidan. The All India Congress Committee launched a mass protest demanding what Gandhiji called an orderly British withdrawal from India. Even though it was wartime, the Britishers were prepared to act. Almost the entire leadership of INC was imprisoned without trial within hours of Gandhiji's speech. Most spent the rest of the war in prison and out of contact with the masses. The Britishers had the support of the Viceroy's Council, which had a majority of Indians, of the All India Muslim League, the Princely States, the Indian Imperial Police, the British Indian Army, and the Indian Civil Services. Many Indian businessmen profiting from heavy wartime spending did not support the Quit India Movement. Many students paid more attention to Subhash Chandra Bose, who was in exile supporting the Axis powers. The only outside support came from the Americans, as President Franklin D. Roosevelt pressured Prime Minister Winston Churchill to give in some of the Indian demands. The Quit India campaign was effectively crushed. The Britishers refused to grant immediate independence, saying it could happen only after the war had ended. Sporadic small-scale violence took over all over the country, and the Britishers arrested tens of thousands of leaders, keeping them imprisoned until 1945. In terms of immediate objectives, the Quit India movement failed because of heavy-handed suppression, weak coordination, and the lack of clear-cut program of action. However, the British government realized that India was ungovernable in the long run due to the cost of World War II, and the question for post-war became how to exit gracefully and peacefully. So, my dear friends, remember that our freedom fighters had suffered a lot for the independence we are enjoying today. We must respect it and remember that each and every protest or movement that our freedom fighters did is the reason we are free today. Thank you very much.
My warm greetings to one and all present here. Today, as the Mrs. Trivedi, I'm here to recite a self-composed poem on the topic Quit India Movement. On the marvelous day of August 8, the father of nation changed our fate. He gave a final blow to the Britishers to leave India and her citizens. Gandhiji feared that India would be attacked, so he tried to save her from Japan's impact. Then he declared, do or die, and asked the people to be not afraid of goodbyes. Congress was banned, people were canned. After the Cripps mission failed, India's freedom was curtailed. Gandhiji inspired thousands by the movement he initiated, but after observing it, the British got infuriated. They arrested common people and waged brutal terror. They tried to suppress the movement forever. After the long struggle, India still survived. And trust me, it only happened due to the hands that combined. Now we stand as a country so stupendous, but all free and enjoying our independence. On the marvelous day of August 8, the father of nation changed our fate. Thank you.